My name is Jonathan Parks, and welcome to Jonathan's Nature Crafts. I must inform you that I do not live in this house by myself, but live here with other people. Sometimes other members of the household may have to walk through areas where I might be recording with other family members on the phone. If you hear any noise like that, please feel free to disregard. We are doing our best to get noise-canceling equipment, which may at least keep you from hearing exactly what is being said. Thank you for considering. Well, I'll tell y'all for this little moment. I decided I might have a little bit more to come on and say, and as for all these little different little cherubs, as far as what we've made here, probably got some more to go with what we've got to do, and probably would say that there's a few more I have that might actually be down in this bag here. Now that I think of it, I'll show you all this bag here. I just pulled on the little tablet cord. That's what made the video turn tip a little corner wise, but here is the bag that I've been taking lately to the Woodcarvers Guild meetings. And it's a new one, just because those old ones I used for years that were given to me randomly, they were just had such thin cloth and the knives were always tearing through them. So got this one recently from Lowe's because it's much better, and just kind of would say that there's little things we kind of want to work on for the moment, and just to say as far as just what all we're going to do, and then kind of show a little where it's all going to come to the side, because, I mean, I'd like to kind of talk about a little more random things while I share just a little bit more work. And you know, over these past times we've been carving the basic steps to these little walnut and Kentucky coffee tree little cherubs here, and I think I might kind of work on the same little steps to the cherry ones today while I just kind of tell y'all a little bit about what's going on. There's people I message often to kind of tell them what goes on in my life and how I do each day, and all the people that, you know, probably got so much cares for in this world, because I say this world can be a little bit of a nicer place sometimes when we all just kind of contribute to it a little bit in what ways we know how or what ways we have. But I think I'm going to take along these very same steps along the eyes of this cherry cherub here. And this is, like I say, to the sets of cherubs 2 and 3. So, like I showed you all before, where we kind of work about this gouge and kind of try to work our way into things, because little work is just kind of what all is what we need when we try our best about the things we have and say and do. And you know, I say that I get the little good extra work done into a piece when I try my best about it, and coming along to it, just get a little thing done in here and kind of take it where we kind of want 3 whole sets of 7 to be done out. And so that's where we're working again even harder and trying our best not to really do ourselves too much harm or cut ourselves or anything in what we do. So is just kind of like one little adventure comes right after another, and we take care of all the little things just in all the best ways we can, because this is just one of those lives we all live. And I say that little things can come our way and make us all see joyful endings and joyful beginnings. Oh, I tell you, I love all this type of work. I'd like to also share with you a little thing about my friend Brenna, who has this little business called Silver Solstice Prints that she has, and has these shirts she made for it recently that she's advertising. She's been kind of running the business a little bit from her own apartment. Couldn't be prouder of her for just all the success she's making. Still have a few of her prints that I purchased, mainly all the ones of the wildlife and animals that I liked. And, you know, she's kind of done some neat things. Those of you who love, like, witches and spooks, I mean, she's kind of done a little bit of that stuff, but, I mean, I tell you, you know, some of it probably isn't really my favorite subjects, but I tell you what I do love is I love all the different types of animals she does. I've got one that has a raccoon and a skunk and an opossum on it, and it's called Trash Gremlins. And there was a certain other artist who I made an online purchase from just yesterday, who is making all this wildlife art, and among her pieces were where she's been doing all these different creatures in these pink backgrounds, and among them there were like these little ones she did of like little trash animals. Like, she did one of the raccoon, one of the skunk, and one of the opossum, and there were certain reasons she advertises on her site as to why she was given those for free. This was an artist I just got introduced to yesterday, and as I'd like to say that it was just some wonderful work I loved to share sometimes. And I mean, I tell y'all that I've just loved a lot of what I've seen, but I think she also just talks about how she really wants people to, you know, not to think bad about those animals, think of them as being too much mischief or anything. And those are the types of animals some people set traps for because they are very mischievous. I don't set traps for anything myself, but could be just as guilty, because sometimes I go on Etsy and buy the furs of animals that were trapped. And, you know, some people think that that's the same. In my opinion, it's not, and I tell you that, you know, I don't have a problem with people who do trap, but, you know, the fact that I just love the animals themselves, and the fact that she's given them away for free and not charging any shipping, was kind of just the reason I went on and purchased them. And I'd say there's probably going to be a lot to show and a lot to say as we go a little further on. There are probably some things in life that have become discontinued products, and that's kind of where some of the work has come along. There's been times in my life when, you know, we've kind of had our little jokes here and there, little things we said and done. And for all things, I say that some of them are funny, some of them are not. I mean, I tell you, and you know, if you work in a high school cafeteria, you know, there's just a lot of immaturity that can go on around young kids, but, you know, we all just kind of handle things differently. we've just got to be our grown selves and kind of handle it better and move on. And for the most part, that's just the kind of thing I'd say I really try to do. Sometimes I might hear a little too much, and then there are some places in life where I sometimes feel like I might have a conviction not to go those places because of things that might be there, things that might happen there, and, you know, just because of little things that could trigger me now and then. But there have been some things in life where I've learned there's going to be little things that sometimes you just can't always get away from in life and in places. And there's going to be things that are going to go on in your workplace and people God's going to put in your path. Sometimes they may not always be something you can move away from or escape from, but sometimes I believe that there's people God puts in your path because He wants you to pray for them. And there are times in my life when I think I've been in some workplaces where sometimes even the things I've had to pray concerning might have even been signs from God that He wanted me to move to other places. And that would be the kind of thing I'd discover for myself as I moved on and found out and learned a lot of good things. Because, you know, you come to realize that when God calls you to move, there's obviously a reason, because obviously He needs you to be in a new field. There might be a reason why somebody there needs you, or why there might be somebody He's called you to serve in that other field. And sometimes I think there's people God puts in our paths because He wants us to pray for them. Sometimes I think there's been some people come in my life to which I've had to apply a little prayer now and then, because there are times when you just sometimes pray and ask God little things, and sometimes the fact that He might speak to you and tell you to pray for that person that for whatever reason they probably really need it, that might just be the reason they're in your path, you know. Sometimes you come to realize that praying for a person might really change things and change ways about things. There's times in my life when I go from place to place and wanted to tell you little things about how I have this show that I go to in Richmond tomorrow morning. I have to kind of get up kind of early in the morning to get out on the road and get there, but and it's going to be a long drive away, but I'd say I'm just rather prepared because we've kind of gotten things ready for that. I've heard a little rattling noise in my car and wanted to go get it checked out this morning, but luckily Dad and I just kind of drove around in it before I went to work, and seemed to be something that was just a little bit normal considering the weather and the weather conditions. So we kind of manage that out pretty well and work our way about it as best as we can, because it is just a little thing that I'd say we certainly need now and then. And, you know, weather changes, and I'd say especially if you consider Kentucky, I'd say, you know, Kentucky is just one of those places where the weather has always been known to change very frequently. And there are certain seasons where that's kind of a little bit more of a case than it is in others, because sometimes it's just kind of one of those things where we have our hot times of year, our cold times of year, and for the different places where we are and different times where we live, we just have different temperatures that go different ways. And you probably also just seen a lot of strange things with the videos and cartoons, because sometimes there's little stunts people can pull now and then and probably not the coolest thing. And, you know, like how in the winter time people do that little polar bear stunt where they jump into the ocean on a cold day. I'd say that some little things are just gonna be silly or funny to us and call us all the way down to the middle of the pathway of the road and see a little silly word or two come down to what it is. I say that we probably came further along on the fronts of these heads, or maybe on the front of one head, but come down and take care of the face on this other one too. Because I tell y'all, a little face can use a little structure now and then. A little face can use a little framing now and then. And I say that this is just kind of work that shall manage us each day and make us all see a little peaceful ways in our lives and merciful little goslings and things. I say, oh, I tell y'all, little beast worship now and then is just a little horrible step to take. I say that there's just a lot of times we work hard at what we do, make things just for what we do for a living and how we kind of manage our time well. I say that there's just times when in our little places we manage the little steps we take and come on and just do crazy little stunts, I say, weird little work, I say, and all, you know, all we can't do is just kind of work on and worship our little paths, because strange little things happen in our lives each day and we don't always know all the reasons why, because we live a life where we see a lot of things that we do not know about and do not understand. And I say that this is just one little way a little work can come in. And I've come along where I've gotten this much done along with the cherub here. And there's just a lot to see in this basement. And I'll tell y'all that there's a little show I have tomorrow. It's at a homemakers club. Really going to enjoy the event, I think. Probably not have a lot of people show up, but to buy or to sell, but I'd say it's always going to be neat just getting out there, meeting people, getting to know people. Always make a lot of new good friends at these events with people I meet and know and trust. And I tell y'all that this is just the kind of work that shall make better people out of us and see a better light and a better way just coming to us, brightening our paths a little more. I tell y'all that we come down to the best work we have and all the things we make right out of it. I say that this is just one little place. I tell y'all that there's just more work to come in than we ever know or realize. I say when it comes down to it, we're getting the faces and heads about equal here. And come down to where we make the faces down to just one little blessed size for all the little things we have in our work, I say. And come down a little bit, make things come out just a little bit more further. And I say that this is just one little object of work that takes its way to us. And of all things, I tell y'all, we see little bright lights and paths glow our way, and trying to kind of get a little bit of more extra work done here. Just go right into the eyes just a little more. Remove a little bit more wood from the rest of the eyes and kind of work a little ways about it to see how this shall come to be and an end to all things, where one of these days a project is going to get so finished we won't have much to put into it anymore. But it all comes down to where there's just kind of like some little blessed type of work to be made in little old things we do. I say kind of like what this is, I say. And there's really not much cheek to put into this, because it comes down to the fact that we kind of got the face and head in and come down to where we're just going to remove a little better wood from the forehead and see crappy places that just need a little bit of extra work done to themselves, I say. Come down to where we'll finish a project just a little bit more as we do go about it the best of our ways, I say. And then kind of make it so it comes out just the way you see it here. And for other little things, I might have a little separate time on which I might carve out the backs of these little heads for these cherry ones. There's just so much to say and do as we work along our ways. And I want to tell you all a little something more, that I love every one of you all and all you all come on to do and what you come on to comment and say. I will say that it's good to have more subscribers sometimes. I enjoy having the extra subscribers when they come along. Appreciate what all you all do just to make this a better channel. Going to try to cut this down to an end here in a little bit, and thank you all for coming on. Wish you all the best. Hope to see you all again. Take care and God bless. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel. I hope to see you in the next video. Stay tuned.